Welcome back, everybody, to the Nexon Arena for more SSL, some Korean StarCraft over here. We've got lots of fans joining us for these epic matches. We're already 2-0 in our second match of the night. We had a 3-0 to begin between Dark and Classic, Dark over Classic 3-0. And now Stats is giving Patience a run for his money, already up 2-0.
Two very close games where Patience was forced to try to end the game or die trying. And in both games, he died trying. We'll see if, as we go into one of our more unique maps, Arena, if Patience can bring it back. He's going to have to win three games in a row. He faces the same challenge as Classic did in the previous series. Looks like the map is nearly loaded, StarCraft fans. Get out there, spread the word about this tournament. We are going to jump into game three right now.
Here we are on Arena for map number three between Stats and Patience. Up in the top left of the map in the red, it is Stats.
And his opponent to the bottom left in blue is Patience. Now this map can often lead to a bit faster of games just simply because of the proximity of bases. Interesting pylon there. I think that might be a zoning pylon for later on slowing down pushes with overcharge, because you can't really get a concave on that pylon if you actually go down the slow path or the narrow path.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll definitely looking to gain control of that specific location either way. Could block some adepts that come across, you know, just make it take more time. It's also going to delay the scout. The scout has to go all the way around, whereas the scout of Patience is already there.
Really smart move here. This map is still not very figured out because it's one of our newer maps. And, you know, it's one of those maps that players have had some time to practice on, but is often banned and vetoed and whatnot. So let's see how these two players are going to open. A much greedier opening here from Patience with simply one gate versus the two gate stalkers that Stats is pulling off here. And he also has scouted such a greedy opening, so he knows it's going to be a quick nexus coming up for Patience.
It's going to be interesting. We do have the same build from Stats' last game, going for just double stalker into Mothership Core, looking to put on that pressure a bit early. This probe is, of course, going to scout the reason he had to go all the way around. And here come the first two stalkers. Can start to, I suppose, force out some photon overcharges from Patience and do a bit of damage to that pylon.
Yep. The overcharge will stop these stalkers coming. We're going to see a four-gate warp prism all in. Or three gates, that looks like. Actually, I thought he was adding three. I think that's actually what we're going to see here. We're just going to see him fly the warp prism across and attack with this one base. He's got a sentry coming out too, which will, you know, be able to force seal the ramp out if anyone's out caught at the natural. Be disastrous. This looks like a wolf build. Like literally what I do on this map.
It's what you gotta do on a map like this, I suppose. There's a reason this is in the pool to create some wild and crazy games, and we may be seeing one right here.
Well, he's going immortal, actually, instead of a quicker warp prism, so I could be totally wrong, but that was my feel. That was like what I was... It's really starting to get the tangles there on what sort of build he was doing, but...
Either way, this game is going to look a lot different, you know. This isn't a build you see all the time. Stats is going to control the bottom of this ramp with his early units and go into a nexus behind this. But I doubt he's going to stick around as long as last time. He doesn't have any sentries in the mix. And I think he's just looking for, you know, some time bought for his nexus, but also to see exactly what Patience is doing.
Patience is almost essentially trying to like reinvent the matchup right now. Great force of heal. We'll actually get him a stalker. But he is going to walk across the map to push this pylon out. But the warp prism is coming up. He's going to probably just drop the Immortal right into that prism and fly across. They might just attack by ground at this point. Really interesting plays. Patience is really just not playing standard. He's not playing macro. He really just wants to kill stats in odd ways. A bit aggressive here, but he should be able to slide his way to the right side.
Yeah, there's not a lot of units here. Just one pylon. And right now, Patience just skirting around the edges there. Doesn't want to take damage, but he's got a lot of units, man. And three at a time coming down with those three gateways and the Warp Prism.
Yep, and he can focus down that pylon with an Immortal here. The Immortal still has barrier, and also that Warp Prism will allow him to micro. No cancel on the Nexus. It's up and completed. No Force Shields either. This might be lights out for stats in game number three. He's actually looking to unpower that that Robotics as well.
Gonna force into their overcharge. That one force field is really nice, and he's actually got some units coming from behind.
Really good Warp Prism burying here. The barrier does not go off. Might have been on cooldown there. A huge warp into Stalkers, and also a Sentry might be able to cut these units in half. Not able to do so in time. It will actually prevent most of them from coming out. Stats is down to 13 workers. Recovering from this is going to be very difficult. He's actually going to be down to 11 because he's going to lose these probes too.
Yeah, really rough spot. Doesn't quite have another force field, but he's got a lot more units, and Stats really doesn't have much of an option to make that many more. Three more Stalkers and an Immortal being produced by Patience. And I think Patience may just have this one. We'll see what Stats is going to be able to do to try to stop this with his Photon Overcharges, but...
The pylon placement isn't going to help him. It's not doing him any favors. It's far away.
Look at that burying. There's just no chance. It's like he's blinking down the ramp.
Yeah, exactly.
GG.
Patience bringing it back. Really cool builds. Every single game out of this guy, he's bringing us something different to the table.
Yeah, and Stats, I don't know. I felt like that was a bit greedy to go for that Nexus that early. I suppose he didn't expect the builds coming out of Patience, and I mean, that's a really short walk from the main to go straight to that natural. This is a pretty short map if you go by the thin path there. So Stats is kind of being caught off guard, and Patience is going to take one game here. So we are going to have a game number four.
That's right. So, you know, I'd have to watch the replay to be certain as to what Stats made after he scouted that he was basically hiding in his base on one base. I feel like he probably rushed out an Observer, which didn't do him any favors there, and maybe he was expecting some sort of D-team play or something, but he just did not respect the fact that he knew his opponent was staying on one base and still took the Nexus. I think you're exactly right.